1/30. And the next one, we are changing the groups here, but the answer will not change. See here, 1/2 into 1/3 into 1/5 is, what is the answer, friends? 1/30 only. That's why we can say that the associative property is equals to, see, A into B into C is equals to A into B into C. It is equals to, the associative property is closed under multiplication. And the next one is division. See, we can say that A divided by B divided by C is not equals to A divided by B divided by C, isn't it? It is not equal. For any rational numbers A, B and C, thus division is not associative in the set of rational numbers. See here, you can see the example, friends. 1/2 divided by 1/3 divided by 1/5. What is the answer? 3/10. Here, 1/2 divided by 1/3 divided by 1/5. It is not equal. The answer will not equal. That's why we can say that the associative property is not closed under division also. And the next property is identity. In identity, see friends, in identity there are two types, are there? In identity there are two types, are there? First one is additive identity. Additive identity. What is the first one, friends? Additive identity. And the second one is multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity. These are the two types of identities. See on the screen, the number 0 is added to any rational number remains the same. See, for example, additive identity is a 0, friends. If we add any number to the 0, for example 1/5 equals to, if we do like this, 1/5 plus 0 is the 1/5 is remains same. This is belongs to rational number. And here, if we add any number to the 0, then the numbers remain same. That is why we call the additive identity as a 0. And the next one is multiplicative identity. See friends, multiplicative identity, we multiply rational number with 1. We get the same rational number as the product. See, multiplicative identity is 1. Multiplicative identity is 1. If we multiply any number with 1, then the answer remains same. See here, I multiplied 1/5 with 1 and 1/5 into 1 also. But the answer remains same here. And it is also belongs to rational number. Okay. And the next one is existence of inverse. In inverse also, there are two types, are there? Additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. Additive inverse is nothing but, if A represents any rational number, then A plus of minus A is equals to 0. See friends, what is the next one? Inverse. The next one is inverse. Inverse. In inverse also there are two types, are there? Additive inverse and multiplicative inverse. Additive inverse and second one is multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse. Additive inverse is nothing but any two numbers whose sum is 0 is known as additive inverse. See, for example, a plus of minus a is equals to 0. Here, what is the inverse of a? Minus a. And what is the inverse of minus a? A. This is the additive inverse of each other, isn't it, Spheros? And the next one is multiplicative inverse. See, I will tell the example of additive inverse. See, for example, 1 by 2 plus of minus 1 by 2 is equals to 0, because plus into minus, minus. 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 remains 0. Okay, Spheros? Next one is multiplicative inverse. See, multiplicative inverse. If A represents any rational number, then A into 1 by A is equals to 1 by A into A equal to 1. In this multiplicative inverse, we are using only the rational numbers. Why, friends? See here, in multiplicative inverse, we are using only rational numbers, because if we multiply with natural numbers, see, for example, 2 into 3 is equals to 6 and 3 into 2 is equals to also 6. But it is not in the form of P by Q. That's why it is not, we can't cancel it. That's why we are not using these numbers. Only we are using the rational numbers. See, for example, 1 by 2 into 2 by 1. Equals to 2 by 2 equal to 1. Okay, Spheros, what you find in this, the 1 by 2 is the inverse of 2 by 1 and 2 by 1 is the inverse of 1 by 2. But I already said, no, Spheros, P and Q all are the integers. We can write all the integers as a rational numbers. Okay, only in multiplicative inverse, what we are using? Yes, we are using only the rational numbers. And the next one is, what is the next property, friends? Distributive property. Distributive property. This property, sixth property. Okay, let us see with the help of screen. Distributive property. If A comma B and C are the three rational numbers, then A into B plus C equals to A into B plus A into C. See here, friends, in distributive property, we are taking three numbers. In distributive property, how many numbers we are taking? Yes, we are taking three numbers. In this distributive property, multiplication over addition is there. Multiplication over addition. Over addition. See, friends, if A is a multiplicative number and B plus C is the sum of two numbers is equals to A into B plus A into C. A into C. Here, A is the distributor, isn't it? A is the distributor whose sum is two numbers is known as distributive property. Multiplication over addition, this is the formula of the distributive property, multiplication over addition. And the next one is, what is the next one? Yes, multiplication over subtraction. What is the next one, friends? Multiplication over subtraction. See, multiplication over subtraction. multiplication over subtraction. Same as like addition, this is also there. See, A into B minus C is equals to A into B minus A into C. This is a distributive property over multiplication. Let us see some examples with the help of screen. See here, A comma B and C are any three rational numbers. Then A into, I already said that. See here, I already said this. A into B plus C is equals to A into B plus C. A into C. See here, one example here given. Let us see. 1/2, 1/3, 1/5. These three is belongs to rational number. Let us do this problem. 1/2 into 1/3 plus 1/5. Here we, these are the sum of two numbers. This is the distributor. 1/2 into 1/3. If we do like this also, we get the same answer. And if we do like this also, same answer. That's why we can say that the distributive over addition is equal in LHS equals to RHS. See here, 1/2 into 1/3. 1/2 is the A. Here, 1/3 is the B. Plus 1/2 into 1/5. Here, 1/2 into 8 plus 8 by 15 equals to 1/6 plus 1/10. What is the result? See, what is the result? When we do multiplication over addition, the answer is 8 by 30 is equals to 8 by 30. Is it equal or not, friends? Yes. Now we are cancelling this both. 2 4s are 8, 2 1s are 2 5s are. This 4 by 15, and here also same like this. 4 by 15. These two are belongs to rational number. Okay, Spheros, this is the multiplication over addition, and this is the formula of the multiplication over subtraction. Okay, and the next one is, see here, identity property. This is the associative property, friends. Changing the group of the numbers will not change the result is known as associative property. I already said now one example, flowers, isn't it? The next one is, this formula is A plus B plus C equals to A plus B plus C. Identity property. 0 and 1 preserves identity. See, this is the additive identity 0. If we add any number to the 0, then the answer remains same. The next one is multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity is 1. If we multiply any number with 1, then the answer remains same. Under addition, this 0 preserves addition and 1 preserves multiplication. And the next one is inverse property. Inverse is nothing but inverse. If we add of any two numbers, we get additive identity. That whatever it may be, the additive identity is 0 and multiplicative identity is 1. Then the numbers are additive inverse of each other. The next one is distributive property. Multiplicative distributes over addition. Lastly, I said no Spheros, this formula A into B plus C equals to A into B plus A into C. This is the distributive property. Okay, friends, what we observe in all these? Let us do this. See here, what we find, what we conclude from the closure property. See, for example, this is the closure property. We already done some problems under this operation: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Let us do with chalk piece. This is different, no? See, closure property is satisfied. Closure property is satisfied under addition, subtraction and multiplication. and also division. And the next property is commutative property. Let us write clearly, friends. You also understand clearly. See, friends, first one is closure property. Closure property. This is under addition, multiplication, subtraction and multiplication, and last one is division. The next property, what is the second property, friends? Yes, second property is commutative property. Commutative property. And third one is associative property. Fourth one, identity. And fifth one is inverse. Okay, friends, we already know that the closure property is satisfied in all. And the next one, commutative property is only satisfied under addition and multiplication. In subtraction and division, it will not satisfied. And the next one is associative property. Associative property is also same as like that. In addition only it will be satisfied, and in subtraction it will not satisfied, and in multiplication it will be satisfied, and in division it will not satisfied. And next one is identity. We already know that in identity there are two types, that are additive identity and multiplicative identity. That's why only additive and multiplicative identity. This subtraction is division is not possible in that. Next one is inverse. In inverse also there are two types, that is additive identity, and the subtraction is not possible in that. And the next one is multiplicative identity, and the last one is division is also not satisfied. What we conclude, friends, from this? Yes, we conclude from this. Hello? Hello, friend. What's your name? Hello, Svera. Hello. What's your name?
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Hello, what's your name, Svera?
Hello.
Hello, what's your name, Svera?
My name is Naomi.
Okay, friend. What's your doubt?
R.K. Puram.
Okay, Svera. What's your doubt?
What is the multiplicative inverse of zero?
Multiplicative inverse of zero. If we multiply, okay, that is a good question, Svera. Now I want to clarify your doubt. What is the multiplicative inverse of zero? Zero. This is a zero. Into, if we multiply any number, what is the answer get? We get the zero only. This is no inverse of anything. Okay. Are you clarify your doubts, Svera? Okay. Next one is, all this we already conclude from these properties of number system. We already done this all chart. Now we already know that how to remember these properties and what is the specialty of those properties. Okay. Thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity to me, and thanks to our beloved secretary sir, and also our principal madam B. Vijayalakshmi garu. Thank you very much, and also all my dear Max teachers, Shailaja madam, Kalimuddin sir, and Annapurna madam, Srilata madam, and all the staff teachers. I very heartfully thanks to you, and thank you, friends. Bye bye.